Now, if you say what people like, I think far most of the people that come and are interested in this, they like the idea of a cohort-organized doctorate program, which, by the way, is a difference also to the PhD program. Very few PhD programs, in fact, none that I know of, are cohort-organized. It's much more individual. Here, it's a cohort, and I think people really like this because these are busy people, these are ambitious people, they move fast, and they know very well that if they're going to succeed to do this while having a job and having a family and having other interests in life, there must be a structure in place, and there must be a social environment that is with a lot of trust, but also with a lot of support and challenges and, you know, learning. And the cohort is the ideal form for creating that context for this type of study. So I think this is one of the things that really attract people. If I should mention one other thing, it is the idea about engaged scholarship. So I think these words, even if there are books written about it and you can start talking about it academically, but I think just these words are rather descriptive of what we are trying to do. The idea about, you know, not sort of staying in the Eiffel Tower and looking at the world and sort of believing that you are smarter just because you're going for a doctorate, but instead being more humble and saying there's a real world out there and it's the real world of business that drives us, and it is understanding this real world, and it is engaging in this real world, and it is trying to contribute to this real world, make it move forward somehow, even in the smallest of ways, while doing research. That idea captures people, and I think they're fascinated about it. This has surprised me, I must say. So the way that the selection happens is, I really say it's by natural selection in a way. So we have tried to develop a very clear communication about what our goals are. And therefore, we have the following experience. We have a lot of people coming to our open houses. We have a lot of people wanting to talk to us on the phone. So we are out there interacting with a lot of people, but rather few of them apply. This is what is a surprise to me. So the way that we really select is upfront in meeting with people, talking to people, and being clear about what this program is. And that simply implies that several people, most of the people we talk to, do not apply. The next thing that happens is, of course, that some apply. And out of those that apply, we select many for interview. So the selection in this next step is much smaller percentage-wise as it was in the first step. And then finally, amongst those that we interview, far most of them that we interview become, I mean, they become accepted into the program. The final selection is then that out of those that become accepted, some decide not to do it anyway. And that's a rather big number. Say that out of those that we accept each year, between probably 25% to 30% of those do not engage that particular year. And the reason I mention this number is that it's a reflection of who the students are. They're very busy people. They have a lot of contingencies to think of. Things happen in their life. Things happen in their businesses. So even up to the last day before we start, people might call and say, "Okay, I thought I could engage, but I cannot this year because our company just merged with this other company, and my boss wants me to take charge of the merger. So I'll wait until next year." So that's the final selection. Is the timing right? It's so important.